Hey everyone, earlier today I vlogged that I would do multiple live streams but also work to adhere to the standard Sunday schedule and at the same time try to weave back into discussing entertainment and pop culture news, and this is the first, if you will, stab at that effort, okay? And stream status is good, ready to go. And I'm going to interweave a discussion that I'm sure is going to ensue based on a series of tweets I sent to the great Oakland Raiders coach Jack Del Rio, but they had to be sent. I'll talk about that later. But first, I want to talk about the whole matter of Kelly Ripa set to announce her new host Monday morning. I was a big fan of Live with Kelly and Michael, and had the pleasure of meeting, hey, Go Cubs, how are you? How was church service, by the way? I had the pleasure of meeting Michael Strahan at the 2008 NFL Draft. And here we go, hey, how you doing? At the 2008 NFL Draft. And, you know, Michael Strahan is a wonderful person, very warm. How he is on television is very much what you get in person. And so it's very easy for me to understand how he was able to rise to the lofty place in pop culture he has attained, all right? Michael Strahan is a hard act to follow. And I've watched Live with Kelly afterward. I'm acquainted with their producer, Brian, among other people, and fine staff, outstanding, okay? Fine people, but the bottom line is this. I don't care who she names as her host in the morning, no one can replace Michael Strahan. They had on recently John Leguizamo, one of the finest actors of our generation, beyond a shadow of a doubt. But he did something during the telecast that made me say, you know, as a host, eh. And what Mr. Leguizamo did was he started talking about things that were depressing. And not in a funny way. When you tune in to a morning show and you're waking up, just about to go to work, and I mean, when I say go to work, I don't mean the classic 20th century, go someplace else to work, but just get your mindset to work. You want to have, and I agree with you, Go Cubs, it would be interesting who you place. You want to have someone that lifts you up in the morning, that makes you smile and laugh, and makes you feel good. And it's interesting how in the process or the objective of trying to have this feel-good show, the producers of Live with Kelly have copied some of James Corden's style where they have everybody high-fiving, all the guests high-five the audience as they come out. You notice that? That's from James Corden. That's from his Late Late Show, okay? And hey, how you doing? They borrow from that. So in this way of trying to have this feel good, right? You've got, hey, what goes on? I was like, oh, I think you were saying, Miguel says, how about The Rock? I think The Rock would be great. And I have to confess, I haven't watched every single Live with Kelly. So I don't know if The Rock played host. Let's find out real quick. Let me go to Google and see if, let's see who's hosted Kelly. All right. Warren Sapp actually might just work. But hold on a second. Kelly Ripa. Let's see. Live with Kelly. With Kelly. Guest hosts. Hosts. And we'll get the answer. There should be a list. TV guest host. There's actually a photograph of who's been on, and I'll show you. Take a look here, right here. All right. Hey, Go Cubs. How you doing? Hey, Maniac. How are you? This is it. She has had. Let's see. There's Jay Leno, Jack D. Those are just TV guest hosts. Period. This is not with Kelly. I'm sorry. I apologize. I was fooled by the search result. Hey, Google's got to work on that. But let me try and list the Late Late Show episodes. List some guests appearing on the late night schedule. The trouble is that Maybe if I lock it in, like lists of live with Kelly guest hosts, maybe if I do a quotation marks, live with Kelly guest hosts, right? Let's see, Ryan Seacrest, Andy Cohen, let's see here, Alec Baldwin, who else? So I have Ryan Seacrest, good guy, met guy Ryan Seacrest, Alec Baldwin, and Andy Cohen. Haven't met him personally, but I've been in the same room with him. We were both having breakfast at the Polo Lounge 5 years ago. Let's see here. And don't see that. Don't see. Oh yeah. Billy Cardell is another host. She's had a number of them. Let me see. There's no full list. It's hard to find the full list of people here. And I think someone mentioned The Rock. So I'm going to say Live with Kelly, and then comma, The Rock. Wait a minute. Live with Kelly. Hey, Barry Lee, how you doing? Live with guest hosts. Live with Kelly guest hosts. Hey, Barry, who do you think should be the guest host on Live with Kelly? And someone said The Rock. I think Maniac said The Rock. And she's had Josh Groban, Jussie Smollett. She's had, wow. There's a list now. Okay, all of Kelly Ripa's live guest co-hosts. Entertainment News has a list. And I will read them all. I think she even had her husband, right? Let's see here. This list is a slideshow. You know what I hate about slideshows on a web page? Is that you're slave to the design of that page and how much, if it has a lot of JavaScript in it and you push it, it's gonna move slow if it moves at all for you, depending on your connection. Anyway, she's had Richard Curtis, who was the winner of Live with Kelly co-host search. Joel McHale, remember Joel McHale? Anderson Cooper, Keegan-Michael Kay, Andy Cohen, John Leguizamo, who I discussed earlier, Guillermo Diaz, Jussie Smollett, David Muir of ABC Newsnight, Ryan Seacrest, Jerry O'Connell, remember from Jerry Maguire, Jim Parsons of The Big Bang Theory, Nick Lachey, now 42 years old, Josh Gad, Alan Cumming from The Good Wife, Christian Slater, Taye Diggs, who we're connected on Twitter. We haven't personally met yet. Tony Goldwyn from Scandal, Carrie Ann Inaba from Dancing with the Stars, Dwayne Wade, Josh Groban, Kevin Hart. And they have Jerry O'Connell back again, and Morris Chestnut, Alec Baldwin, D.L. Hewley, Mark Consuelos, I believe I mentioned Anderson Cooper before, Common, Seal, a woman once told me I look like Seal, Fred Savage, Daniel Day Kim, Cedric the Entertainer. Now he would be pretty good. Cedric the Entertainer would be pretty good. All right. Jimmy Kimmel. And that's it. That's a lot of guest hosts. That's a lot. So who she's going to pick out of that? Let me put it this way. I didn't see The Rock. Okay. So Brian Gidry says, I bet it's Jerry O'Connor. He needs a job bad enough. You know, I'm gonna say it's probably going to be Kevin Hart. That's just my guess. I think someone who's effervescent, either Kevin Hart or, let's see here, what did Cat Williams say? I didn't see that one. Tom Hanks, let's see, you say you agree with Tom Hanks about, yeah, okay, cool. Tom Hanks. Yeah, but Tom Hanks wasn't a guest, right? And She had the fat kid from Stand By Me. Yeah, that was Josh Gad, who has that voice. Is, I don't know if I could, I want to hear that voice in the morning. Nothing against Josh Gad, all right? Maniac says, I would love to see Shaq. That would be good too. Which, you know, reminds me, does it have to be someone that she's had on as a guest before? I would think you'd want someone as a tryout. Yeah, I would think you would want someone as a tryout. So, Jerry Connell, that doesn't kind of move, that doesn't move the needle. I would think you need someone that really moves the needle, right? Cedric the Entertainer, Kevin Hart moves the needle. Who else? Anderson Cooper moves the needle because he's professional, right? And he's done that live show format before. I think the only question is, can he handle that and do a CNN routine? So, as good as he might be, you know, there's a question there. The let's see here. What are we saying? Barely says, I wonder if she'll ever get a permanent host. I don't know, you know? Golden State, I have no clue. It's great. Hey, Golden State, I'm going more to my standard format of pop culture and sports because it was just the Raiders before, and I'm going back to spreading out. So, Kelly Ripa is supposed to announce her host in the morning, and I'm discussing that, and then I'm going to go into the Raiders. But I don't want to be a one-trick pony. My mind as a Zinster is not structured that way. I mean, I know there are other people who do, but I just have to talk about the world. Charlie Sheen would be great. Do you watch Maniac? Do you watch Anger Management with Selma Blair, who one of my favorite actresses? I always wanted to meet Selma Blair. She's outstanding. Brian Geary says, winning. Thank you. Thank you, Brian. Appreciate it. Thank you. I mean, it's just this big world out there. And not only that, I'm really interested in the idea of developing this into the talk radio of the future, right? Instead of turning it on and you're on the radio, you can have this and then use Skype and bring in guests and have a more of a free form discussion. And we have the exchange with you all posting your comments and here. So I think this is the future right now. Gold Cubs said, I had a dream that I was the Raider owner. I hope you treated Zinni. You can talk Chinese. I'll still follow you. so to say, that's as much Japanese as I know. Chinese, I got to work on that one. Did anyone happen to see, I think it was Steve Harvey's show with the kids tap dancing tonight? I saw that for maybe a few minutes. It was hilarious. that was very nice, Golden. And so that was quite nice. Zinni Two Shoes. Rick Rice, that reminds me of something John Russo used to call me. He used to call me Zinni Loafers. And John's, you know, New York Italian, all right? And he had a nickname for everybody. I was Zinni Loafers, and then, you know, so on. And John was, I say, Oakland's best city attorney ever. He was Oakland's first elected city attorney in 2000, was reelected three times. And that study that you may have seen that introduced the different plans for an A's stadium in 2000, you could thank John Russo for that. He personally paid for that out of part of the city attorney budget to make that go, and then took a tour of baseball stadiums. That's the kind of leader that we have. We had people like Russo and others, the Raiders would still be here. But I want to make a point about some tweets I sent to Mr. Del Rio. In fact, you know what? I'll intertwine that right now. Let me get this out of the way. Jack Del Rio put out a tweet that I thought was unfortunate, and basically it accused a fan who has deleted the tweet. I didn't see what it said of jumping off the bandwagon and not standing with the Raiders. Jack Del Rio is one of the best coaches and one of the finest people I've ever personally met. I'll say that straight off. His Hayward High Foundation is outstanding, and I consistently sing its praises. Just because he is the coach of the Raiders does not mean he has to go and blast other Raider fans or not understand them. I get his passion. He's saying, hey, look, you're not for us. No, I'm for you. All right, I'm for you. But the Raiders have been consistently against the city of Oakland, and I can count to you the number of times. All throughout, okay? All throughout. I wish the coaches and the players would simply stay out of this. not send out tweets, just sit down and get ready for the season and give us that great on the field product and let the off field stuff take care of itself without their occasional comments. It hurts. And in the case of the Raiders, Mark Davis and Mike Silver was there when it happened, asked me to come up with a stadium plan. I did. And I said before, you say it again in ML, a lot of you have heard this before, so I don't want to bore you with it. You know what I'm saying, all right? Hey, how you doing? Welcome. Welcome, Loopy. How are you doing? You know what I'm saying, all right? But the truth has to be told that the Raiders have never once brought a stadium plan or design to the city of Oakland and said, help us build this. Not once. Not at all once. When they came back, I said to the Oakland City Council, hey, because we only rebuilt half the stadium, we're going to have to revisit at some point building the stadium for the Raiders in the future and for the A's. The Oakland City Council member Larry Reed spearheaded an attempt to build a new stadium for the Raiders. Trouble is that then new Governor California, Governor Jerry Brown, took the rug out from under us by killing redevelopment law and tax increment financing, so we were stuck. Had it not been for that, we would have been able to move faster on a Raiders stadium, and the Raiders know it. The Raiders know it. But did the Raiders try to help by getting a tech community involved or someone as an investor and build a privately financed stadium? Nope. Not at all. Not at all. Okay? So my point is that Jack Del Rio is an outstanding person, but I really wish he would not send out tweets like that, because we stand with the Raiders. But here's the thing, all right? When the Oakland fire happened, where was Mark Davis? And I'm talking about the warehouse fire. Where was Mark Davis? Where were the Raiders? When Doctor Strange came out last October, I went to the Grand Lake Theater to see it. Donalda sold me my ticket. She died in the fire. There's another guy, Ben, who was a regular singer at the Alley at 3325 Grand Avenue. He died in the fire. People who are tapestries of our community. And in all this, the Raiders only think about themselves, not the city. And so we're supposed to turn around and say, oh, that's okay. Enough is enough. Oakland has been beaten up enough. Someone has to stand for Oakland and do so without fear. I'm standing for Oakland. You're standing for Oakland. But Coach Del Rio, if he's going to say anything, he ought to stand for Oakland too. If he's fearful of pissing off his boss, I get that. But don't hurt us in the process. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Now, back to the rest of the discussion. Sorry. Golden State Raider says, but Jack is an all-time Raider fan, so he has the right to respond. But I get, oh yeah, hey, look, Garden State, I'm sorry. I'm not criticizing his right to tweet. I'm talking about how it makes me feel. I'm not speaking for anybody else. Me, as a person who's been involved in this. And, you know, I've seen this now. We had Derek Carr and now Coach Del Rio. It's like, you know what? Come on, folks. Why? Why do that? You know, it's not necessary. Thank you, Richard. Golden State Raider says, Zinni, I read the article that says Oakland is high on crime rate because low-income housing. We have had a consistent crime problem, that is true. But you want to tell me that Vegas has a great, you know, no crime issue? I mean, look, I just read the other day. You're going to go to a city that's got an issue with, you know what I'm saying. I don't want to get in that discussion because I don't hate Las Vegas. And I don't like the way that makes me feel. I like Vegas. And it's because of my love for Las Vegas that I am not happy that this issue exists, okay? I think Las Vegas is a great town. I think the mayor of Las Vegas is a great person from what I've been able to see. Steve Sisolak and others. This should not be. The simple fact of the matter is that the center of this is an organization that has not treated the city of Oakland and the Oakland well. And that is a fact. You're talking to a guy who almost brought the Super Bowl to Oakland. Think about this. If I landed the Super Bowl for the Raiders, I would have made them rich with Super Bowl tickets. An average value of $3,000 per ticket on the street. Because of me, okay? Helping the Raiders out like that. So you want to tell me that I haven't tried to help the Raiders? Forget it. I'm not listening. All right. Thanks, Golden State. Thanks. So anyway, Rick Rice, no matter what a coach player says about the move, they're going to be wrong. Just stay out of it. That's all I'm saying, because it hurts. You know, just let us cheer for you. Don't do that. And Brian Geary, sounds like Major League Baseball is going to try to milk Vegas for an expansion team. Could be. It could be. Unless the Democratic-controlled legislature says, hey, you know what? This is getting a little much. That's what I'm saying. Now, let me go back and say who I think, as far as Kelly Ripa. I think Kelly should just host the show herself. Okay? I don't know that she needs a sidekick or a companion. I think she ought to just simply go and maybe, you know, there's some people who are okay doing a solo act, right? Maybe she's not one of them. Maybe she's not one of them. I wonder if there's any hint of anyone's dropping who that new guest might be on Twitter. Let me see what's happening here. I just want to take a gander at it just in case here. Let's see. Kelly. As I try, Kelly Ripa co-host. Actually, you know what? It's a major search here on Twitter. Kelly Ripa co-host. Unfortunately, Ripa has passed on me being co-host, says Central Dad. Ripa to announce her live, this is 55 minutes ago. This is like fresh news. And let's see here, nobody seems to know anything. No one seems to know anything. And meanwhile, Barely says, Golden State, Vegas is worse, it's too bad. It's so bad that the one TV station there every day airs a segment called Squatter Alert because squatters are taking over abandoned homes and businesses. That's a problem around the country. Brian Guidry says, seeing how she can't get along with her male co-host, a solo show would be best. Yeah, I mean, you know, the thing that bothers me the most about Kelly is, you know, she used to be jacked, man. Let me show you something. I mean, she had, like, she was buffed. And then she just, I don't know if somebody, one of the producers got to her or what. But let me show you one of these photos of how Kelly used to, like, really work out. And she looked like a female bodybuilder. She was great, you know? Watch this. This was great. I mean, okay. Watch this. No, buffed, all right? She's mother of three, and there. This is Kelly Ripa. I want you to see this, all right? Yeah, she's a twig now. Somebody got to her. Look at this. That's Kelly Ripa, all right? That's how she used to look, okay? I mean, I was like, whoa, are you kidding me? Hello. And then I think there's another photo of Kelly. Let's see here. Is that her? No, that's not her. I think that's here. Yeah, there's another one. Okay. And here's another one. Okay. I mean, she used to, like, you know, she had the push up and plank contest. I mean, she was working it, man. And then she just kind of, you know, let it kind of go. I don't know. You get the idea. Something happened there, all right? Where Kelly wasn't maybe discouraged to have the muscle. That's really a shame. I'm a big fan of the athletic woman. Now, Bison for Life. Hey, how you doing, Bison? Says she's 46, Hollywood tosses women out after age 30. Isn't that horrible, though? And Barry Lee says, Golden State, if I had the money to fly there and watch a game, I would. Now, Brian Guidry says, Zinni, do you have any inside knowledge as to why Sandy Alderson dropped out of the stadium deal? No, I can find Sandy Alderson from the, Sandy Alderson was involved in the Raiders Las Vegas stadium deal? Let me see here. Golden State, is that what you're saying? Let me Google that. I didn't realize that. I mean, I can definitely find out because I know someone who knows him. Barely says, all the work probably ended her workouts. Rick Rice says, USADA got to her. Golden State Raiders says, how come they don't toss the Kardashians then? It's a great idea. It's a great point. Great point. Let me see, you said Stanton. Yeah. So Brian Guidry, you were saying Sandy Alderson was involved? Let me find out. I'll find out, because I know someone who'd ask. Sandy Alderson, Las Vegas Raiders? Let me see here. I'm typing this in Twitter. The Raiders. Oh, the Sand CEO. I was thinking Sandy Alderson, you're thinking about. I'm thinking about the A Sandy Alderson, but the other Sandy Alderson was CEO of Las Vegas Sands. And that's different. Okay? That man works for Sheldon Adelson. Alright? So there you go there. Zinni, you must have millions of frequent flyer miles. Eh. So no comment there. United is the best in the world. I will say United Airlines is just fantastic. I'm still curious about this whole Kelly Ripa thing, though. Let's see what else we've got here. We've got any new tweets? No tweets. No guesses regarding co-hosts. No nothing. No news. This is terrible. It says she's going to make a big announcement about her new live co-host. Let me see if she's put anything else on Twitter. I ought to ask Kelly if she's going to work out and, you know, bring back the way she used to look. Let's see here. Oh, let's see. There she is. She's a mother, wife, mother, dragon slayer, and shoe lover. And she has 1.81 million fans, of which followers, which I am one. And she's taking a drink out of her mug over 9 hours ago and says, "We're going to need a bigger mug. Tune in to live." But, yeah, and so there's no hint. Wait a second. Maybe there is a hint. Maybe this is the hint. Take a look at this. This is on her Twitter. Mark Consuelos. I think it's her husband, right? So her husband would be the co-host? I don't know. Okay. I'm still curious here regarding why Kelly got rid of the athletic look. So I'm gonna go back and try some other kind of search here. Let's see here. This will work. It's funny how people have kind of photoshopped her body, even though, here we go. This is what I found. This is even better, folks. Have a look, right? This is it. That's Kelly. Then Kelly. Then Kelly, okay. Then Kelly, all right. I guess maybe it was when she did that they got upset. I don't know. And then Kelly. And then Kelly. And, yeah. Kelly Ripa, and then Kelly Ripa. And then Kelly Ripa. So, she had it going on, and she was quite proud of her body. I miss that Kelly. You know what? If Kelly went back to that, she wouldn't need a co-host. Now, how old are her kids? Maybe that's the reason. Bison for Life, that's a good point. Brian Gilder, All My Children. That's a show I haven't heard about in years. You know, All My Children, Brian, let me come back to that. Barry Lee says her and her husband were actors together on All My Children. Ah, okay. Barry Lee says Mark can't because he's doing a show in L.A. Okay. Bison for Life. Any designs yet for the Vegas Stadium? The Falcons' new stadium is behind schedule. No. In fact, Bison, the only design there is the old Carson one. That's it. There's nothing new. And reportedly, they're working on drawings. I was told that by Steve Sisolak, the county commissioner, 2 months ago, a month and a half ago. Okay, a lot of people are, quote, hard at work, right? And I don't mean to say that as if I'm putting down the effort. I'm not. My point is that I haven't heard anyone say that the Raiders have put out a call for construction bids. And the reason why they haven't put on a call for construction bids is because they don't really know what the stadium's going to look like yet. That Carson image is precisely that. And there's a question of whether or not you can actually make that design work in the climate of Las Vegas. You can't just take something that was designed for one area like Carson and just say, I'm going to use this in the desert. That's basically what you're trying to do. Okay. Now, so 2021, I would say 2022 Golden State, if it gets that far. I still am very doubtful about this project personally. It's more complicated than I believe the Raiders are ready for right now. And it's too rushed, okay? Stephen Collins, need to own property first before you can design. That's a great point. And see, once they get the property, then they've got to do the stadium, you know, the land transfer agreement, because that has to be, they have to buy it, right? And here's another sticky issue. They have to buy the land, because the Stadium Authority is not going to do it, and they have to give it, they have to transfer it to the Stadium Authority. That's not the Raider way. The Raider is, hey, you give us the land for free. Okay? Just saying. All right? Barry says, I say, that's hilarious. 3001. Oh, Barry, that's hilarious. Meaning this Las Vegas thing may not happen, says Crawford 371. That's very possible. Bison for Life says, so there'll be a placeholder stadiums for the next 3 to 5 years. You know, Oakland needs to simply grab this thing by the throat, come up with a stadium design, like, you know, I came up with a plan. Come up with a plan that, well, excuse me, let me say something. We have a plan, but finish the job. Come up with stadium renderings beyond that land use vision that we saw from the, by the Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill architect, but focus specifically on the stadium. Peg it to a specific, we have it pegged for a specific cost. Give a visual of what it's going to look like, you know, with the models and video, and turn it, just turn this thing around and say, okay, we are ready because we believe we're better than Vegas, and here is the future of Oakland. Rather than this passive aggressive, willy-nilly stuff that we've been going through and putting Fortress through, I might add, because Fortress Investments is a fantastic corporation that really should be given an award for stepping in and helping Oakland when it did. Just saying. Crawford says, Davis needs to swallow his pride and make amends with Oakland. Hey, Bernard, how you doing? Stephen Collins says, layout, yes. Oh, Bison for Life, okay, All My Children. You know, All My Children was a show that when I was at Texas Arlington as an undergraduate, for lunch used to walk into the student union, and the student union had these high back chairs that you sank into them, and they engulfed you. They're ultra modern and they surrounded you like that, right? And you could sit there, you could fall asleep if you wanted to, and just watch these soap operas. And so, I mean, look, okay, I went in to watch the soap operas because, frankly speaking, all the cute girls were watching the soap operas, and that was the idea. So, hey, college, right? Well, that's what you do, right? So, and I was there, you know, only had maybe an hour before the next class, tops, unless I ate and I got in, you know. That was fun. But that's how I watched and got hooked on All My Children and General Hospital. Okay. Let's see here. Now, hey Bernard, Brian Gidry's, were you a part of Fortress Group? Any links on your proposal? Well, here's a link, but I wasn't part of Fortress, no. But here's a link to my Oakland Coliseum reboot plan. Reboot right here. And then, let's see here. Open Coliseum reboot. It's funny how you have to go to Google. If you go to Google, it comes up right number one, but I'm gonna save you the trouble, and I'm gonna say, there is the link. Ta-da, right there, okay? Bison for Life says, people scheduled their college classes around soaps in the early to mid 80s. I did. That was me, Bison for Life. That was me. Hey, is John Marks here? Okay, Brian, see ya. Brian Guidry, Zinni, where are you? Okay, Barry Lee, I wonder at this point if the Fortress Group has moved on. I hope Not, I hope not though. I hope they're still in it to win it. I can say they're in it. They're not completely out of it. Let's see here. Hello G. Hey, Hallowed, how are you? LA politicians are delusional about LA traffic during sports events. Okay. Golden State Raider. Bro, why don't they let you more involved in the Oakland movement? You seem to know more about what you're talking about sometimes. I get you. Maybe 1/16 of the time. I talk, all the time. 1/16 of the time I'm right. But see, my theory is that the more I talk, the more chances I'll be right by volume, right? Just kidding. But the whole point is just a joke, because bro, you're for real. You should be a part of the team. I thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you. And look, ask the mayor. But I'll tell you something. If you want to know how I feel about this, have a look at this. And I'm not done with what I'm about to show you, but I am showing you. And does that link work? It does work, okay? So have a look there. Let's see here. Rick Rice, it made me want to punch my TV when Sisolak announced the draft pick. He was probably a Patriots fan. Oh boy. Bison for life. LA is contention for the 2024 Summer Olympics. Will that move the timetable forward if the city beats out Paris? You mean LA is no connection with Vegas? Denver considering to put a bid in 2026 Olympics. What are y'all thoughts? Oh, I guess we're just talking Olympics. Great point. Hey, love to talk about that. LA is on its surface a more logical, it seems like a better choice, right? But look, it's the bid. You've got to see what they're going to put in for the bid. Denver has a great airport. It could be a serious Olympic bid player. Why not? Why not? But LA just seems like a natural place. LA and the Olympics, it's been there before. The history, the infrastructure. I have to see the bid. I know Casey Wasserman's behind it. That nutcase from UCLA. Did I say that? Well, look, the only reason I say that is because, all right, I met Casey Wasserman. And this is what happened. This is what happened when I met Casey Wasserman, folks. This is funny. Zinni 62. 62. All right. Casey Wasserman. I thought this was funny. Here we go. All right. This was Casey Wasserman. I may get a message for Mike Silver at the time. Hold on a second. Excuse me. Whoops. Sorry about that.
Hey,
Sill.
Mike. Hey, by the
Hey.
way.
He's no longer the man, the myth, or the legend. He's the winner of the 2020.
Okay.
He's no longer the man.
So let me put that on pause there. Let me enlarge this out. Folks, this is Casey Wasserman. Okay? And here we go. Right there. Okay.
He's no longer the man, the myth, or the legend. He's the winner of the 2021 Super Bowl. Nice to meet you, Casey. And
What's up, hey,
Sill.
Mike? Hey, by the
Hey.
way, Cal sucks.
Oh, wait. Hey, wait a minute. I cannot. Go Bears. Say, come on, go Bears.
Come on, go
Go Bears.
Bruins.
Go Bears. There you go.
All right, so that. A little fun there with Casey Wasserman, the head of the LA Olympic bid for 2024. That was after Los Angeles won the right to host the Super Bowl. That was last year. And yeah, that was the last year. And this is, look, Rams 2029 vision, by the way. That's interesting. And okay, I'm gonna spare you that. That's kind of teasing. Let's see. Joe Mixon did get drafted, and Ashley. And hey, you know what? The Bengals drafted Mixon 46, 48th. Joe Mixon made up with his accuser, forgot her name, and they've moved on, and so I moved on. That's it. I only said, hey, what happened to Ray Rice? Am I still supportive? No, I'm still questionable. I'm holding out hope that this man, young man, has really turned it around. Am I surprised that he got drafted? It's not that I'm surprised, I'm disappointed. Okay? There's a big difference between surprise and disappointment. I'm disappointed he got drafted because of the message it sends. You don't hit a woman. This isn't a matter of being right or wrong. This is a matter of something that was done, okay? That was wrong. All right? So, and am I surprised more of Rixon being drafted by the Bears didn't get the draft. It was the Bengals, okay? Again, I'm going to repeat that. It's not surprise, it's disappointment. It's not surprise, it's disappointment. I'm disappointed. When he was taken, I was more like, oh, that's disappointing. I mean, nothing surprises me. I was disappointed. I was disappointed in the league allowing it. I was disappointed in what seems to be an overly permissive attitude. I'm happy to talk and change subjects and talk about Nick Saban. Thank you for asking, Ashley. Nick Saban, what happened was that the red carpet is first come, first served. The history of it at first was you had to actually come there, it was smaller, and you have to jockey for position. And sometimes the PR people that represent the NFL they have their assignments to do, and they're probably new, sometimes they're young, and they don't want to mess up in their jobs, and so they are instructed to move along the talent, right? Coach Saban's the talent. But I wanted an interview with Coach Saban. And so in my head, I simply reacted when I saw him. I said, Coach Saban, Cam Robinson is the antidote to Myles Jarrett. And I repeated it. And you can see it on the video. I repeated it until Coach Saban came forward and he sang the praises of his star offensive tackle, Cam Robinson. That's what I wanted. And that's how that happened. And I thank Coach Saban for being the kind of person that I really have always sensed that he was. That was my first time meeting him in that way. Anyway, really, who was a person who would come out to the media and speak for his players. He did that to Paul Feinbaum. I talked about this the other night briefly. I don't know if you all remember when Cam Robinson was accused of allegedly using marijuana in his car. He was stopped by a cop and all this. And he wasn't charged or anything, and there was no warrant filed. But, and I want to note that, okay, for something I'm going to say right here, okay. But what happened was that, in spite of the fact that he wasn't charged with anything, Paul Feinbaum of ESPN made it sound like there was this bad thing. This was an SEC media day, okay? And so, and thank you very much, Marina Bruno. Thank you. Or whatever, I don't know. But the whole point is that, I don't know what that was about. But my whole point is that Coach Saban dressed down Paul Feinbaum. I mean, completely. Did anyone ever see that? How he dressed down Paul Feinbaum? Did you guys see that? And Crawford says, keep the east end of the stadium straightened out the ends. Okay. Okay. Well, Barry, if she's promoting her channel, that's okay. I mean, she was advertising herself. Okay. That's, you know, let me talk to a person like that. You know, that's, if she's not saying anything bad, that's okay. I didn't get a chance to look at it, is what I was saying. It seemed, if she has something on her YouTube channel, you know, fine, okay? Okay, that's cool. I have no issue with that over some of the other stuff people have been blocked for, which is really legitimate. Ashley says, are you going to the NHL draft? No, but I should, because Ashley says, San Jose Sharks after last year's Stanley Cup Finals need to retool for next season. You know, that's a weak spot in my focus, and I'm going to make that stronger. Thank you for bringing that up, Ashley, very much. Nah, that's okay. Barry is great. Thank you. Thank you, Barry, for unblocking. Very much. And marijuana doesn't kill. Oh, Brian Guidry, just watch most of your proposal. Interesting, that actually could have worked, but I doubt they wanted to retain Mount Davis, East Side. I wonder what happened to Oracle now once Golden State leaves. Brian, that's a good question, because there's one proposal by an as yet unnamed biotech firm. I am told this has been tried to keep under wraps by higher ups, but wants to buy the Coliseum if it's vacant, which would include tearing down the Coliseum. When the mayor and I were talking about this before we stopped talking, I said to her that we need the convention space to tear down Oracle blindly is ridiculous, because we lose convention space, we lose arena space. You know, why do that? For more jobs of a type that don't employ a number of Oaklanders. That doesn't make any sense. So anyway, Feinbaum rags Saban on his ESPN, all that. Is that right? Oh, let's see here. Now, what did I miss here? A's need a baseball stadium. And you said you grow outdoor marijuana for needy elderly patients, no profit. But God bless you for doing that. That's really something. Garden State Raider says, the one thing I don't get about the vote to let the Raiders move to Las Vegas, it shouldn't be allowed to be voted the same day it was presented, when you don't know and can't know all the facts. That is the why I believe there's something else that's gone on with this. And I'm still trying to figure out what that something else is. Rick Rice says, hey, I'm immediately elderly patient. That's cool. Crawford 371, Feinbaum is pro Auburn. That's interesting. You know, I want to find that video. Let me see if I can find that video. Saban versus Paul Feinbaum. I thought that was classic. This is Feinbaum. Saban versus Feinbaum. Let me see if I can find that one. Yeah, watch heated exchange. Here it is. I found it, folks. You gotta watch this, okay? You gotta watch this. Okay, it's right here. Hold on a second. I found it. I found it. Right here. All right, here we go. Yeah, it's heated, but I can't see anything. I can't hear anything. I can't hear anything, okay? So, hold on a second. Let me get one that's a little better than that. That's not cool. Let's see here. Here's another one. Nick Saban goes off on Paul Feinbaum. Oh, let's see what's going on. Let's see here. Bah. See, it's just these hard to. There it is. Doggone it.
On the set right now. You got to meet with the masses. You got to start the day. I know you've been going room to room, and I know that you did eventually.
I can't hear that very well.
Cam Robinson, but not everybody watching us has seen.
Let me find a better one, folks. I can't hear that one well at all. That's terrible. That's not a good one. Let me try to find another one. The volume on that one was horrible. Just horrible. Here's. Okay. Is this that same one without the. I can't hear anything with that one. Hold on. Oh boy. Let me try video here. Just click on video, right? The problem with clicking on video here is, let's see here. Now, this might work. I still can't hear that one either. God, they upload these videos. You can't hear anything. This is garbage. I can't hear a thing. Maybe this one.
Yeah. That's nothing there either. It's really hard to find a truly decent video on this. It really is. Boy, this is bad. Let me see this. Let me see if this works. I can't find a decent one. Can't find it at all. That is bad. Let me see something here. Let's see here. ESPN. You would think somebody would have a decent, you know, a decent. Okay, here we go. First take. Maybe we're gonna get a catch a break here, huh? Maybe.
Not the end of the conversation for us, though. Paul Feinbaum, Nick Saban on the SEC Network Media Day Wednesday.
Here we go.
Obviously a little heated there, and Feinbaum said Saban was more upset about the circumstances that hit the arrest of the all-SEC left tackle Cam Robinson and reserve defensive back Lawrence Jones than he was upset at Feinbaum himself. But Monty, I want to start with you. Was Feinbaum out of bounds asking those questions to Saban?
No, fair question. I mean, look, you've got a really good player who has been arrested. Your first game is a big one against Southern Cal.
Okay, fine. I still don't see the exchange. I see these guys talking about it.
We know these suspensions had this.
It's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I cannot find anything here. This is ridiculous. Okay, anyway, well, the whole point is I even came to his defense there, okay? And I wonder if I said he blasted him. Did I have anything there?
When there's been a lot of noise about...
Oh, no. Even I'm lame here. Okay, sorry, folks. I can't find a decent video of the actual exchange. It was classic. It was classic. Even I'm lame here. I didn't even actually take a video of the dang thing. Blah! Blah. Anyway. Hey, Zinni, can you talk about our draft picks? Where was our biggest hole on defense? Hey, Rick Rice, I'll get to that in a second. Let's see here. 831 Scott Zinni, were there as many Raider fans this year's draft as a past draft, or did you see a drop-off in fan support? I was in Philadelphia, okay? So all I saw were Eagle fans. And I don't know if you saw Drew Pearson taking on the Eagle fans, but this was my 12th straight year at the NFL draft, period. I mean, the NFL draft. 2004, I went to Raider headquarters. And I went to Raider headquarters in 2003, okay? But in 2004, because I felt like I was away from the action, I made a solemn vow to go to the draft, and I called Joe Brown, then the NFL Executive Vice President for Government Affairs, who remembered me from my Super Bowl bid, and he got me into the draft, where I was the first to cover the NFL draft with a YouTube channel, then live stream with Ustream, and so on. That's how it started for me. So I was in Philadelphia, and all I saw were Eagle fans. Did I see a single Raider jersey? Nope, not at all. I'm sure there was somebody around with one, but were there like hordes? No, not at all, no. And no, not at all. Let's see here. Rick Rice, as far as the draft picks, I gave it a B. And I gave it a B there. And the reason why I gave it a B is because I felt then, and I said before, that I thought the Raiders should have taken Cam Robinson at 24. And he would have been the perfect antidote, not just to Myles Jarrett, but to the Donald Penn issue. He would have been the perfect plug-and-play replacement at that position. Now, some people, like my friend Rick Serratella of NFLDraftBible.com, believe that Robinson's a right tackle. But this is the way I play it. I say, now, you know, Reuben Foster would have been great. He would have been great. But Cam Robinson just is the perfect match of need, team, and player, right? But I digress. Because I contend that a lot of the Raiders' issues, and I've said this last night, are more scheme oriented than talent. Okay, so anyway, but that's why I felt Robinson would have been much better. Oh, and Bison for Life says the property of ESPN may have been pulled. That's true. And yeah, that's true. And let's see here. Melvin Lovejoy, there weren't many Raider fans in Las Vegas either. Funny to watch. You know, that was not a large turnout. You could quite literally count the people that were there. I would say maybe 50? Maybe? That was it? Las Vegas is not excited about the Raiders. I'm sorry. It just isn't there. And there's every indication that had this been put to a public vote, the subsidy, they'd have voted it down. So, CBS, Golden State Raiders says, I got an alert from CBS, Raider fan will be upset over draft picks. How would they know? That's interesting. Rick Rice, we need defense too. Barely. You can never be short of good defenders. And see, Barry Lee says, since they didn't take Cam, I give him a C+. Thanks, Barry. All right? Thank you. And let me see. Brian Guidry, I think he had something there. All right. Maybe Paul is tired of Phyllis from Moga, Alabama. Ceiling show Baradium constantly. That's hilarious. Ashley Arrington. It was televised in big story when Feinbaum worked for Fox Alabama. Maybe Feinbaum just picks on Saban because it's clickbait. You know, he knows it's going to get him attention. Like when Feinbaum said that Warren Sapp was a loser, which I thought was a horrible comment to make. Citian, hey, how you doing, Citian? Citian Foster would have been good. Still too many questions, but if Conley will more likely place Sonny Smith on outside, which he was bad at going up against speed wide receivers last year. You know, Conley, I think, is going to be a good pick. I just, again, don't believe there was a better selection at 24 than Cam Robbins. First game Tuesday for Warriors, that's right. We got drafted a guy with a rape investigation, a legally blind tackle. Although I'm told that David Sharp says he's not blind. So something there, all right? Hey, Rich, Mr. Achuleta, thank you. Great to see you. See you soon. And I'm going to stop, I think, about 1:45 or so, because it's late here in the East. And I've gone on now my plan was to go on for an hour, okay, rather than 2 hours because of the time. Yes, but isn't there a question about Cam's health? Let me see that. I have heard that, but, you know, there's always something about, oh, this person's health is this or that. Like John Robinson's like, oh, let me see this. Cam Robinson. Health. Let me see what's written about Cam Robinson. No, it just says that he had a very erratic wonderlick, whatever that means. Nick Saban updates Cabin. Oh, here's one. By AI.com, Nick Saban updates Cam Robinson's health, calls him Alpha Dog. And, had I known, I would have asked Coach Saban about that. But, let's see here. Immediately after the drill was over, Cam Robinson popped in and started giving the left side of the offensive line a little advice. And, let's see. Alabama star left tackle hasn't been participating in team drills while still rehabbing from a shoulder injury suffered during the regular season, but that hasn't stopped him from making an impact in the spring. With seniors Ryan Kelly and Dominic Jackson out, well, Ability, the rising junior. Yeah, this was March 30th of last year. So, he's healed from that. I mean, obviously he healed from that because that season he took on and arguably defeated Miles Garrett. All right? So there. And I'll be there Tuesday to my couch watching. Ditto. Was there a reason I thought why Cam's stock dropped? I think it was that plus that whole deal. Barely have a food night, Zinni. Keep up the good work you're doing. Thank you. So I'm going to stop in about 4 minutes myself. Yeah, Corbett. Hey, Corbett, thank you. Great to see you. Thank you all very much for tuning in and participating. It's 11:40 in Denver. It's 1:42 here. You know, I went to the gym earlier. So, yeah. Golden State Raider. Yeah. Golden State Raider have, you know, have hot buttered popcorn. That's what I'll do. I'll get hot buttered popcorn, and my mom and I will watch it in comfort on the big screen. Yes, absolutely. Have fun, 831. You guys are awesome. You guys are... Yeah, 831 Scott, you're going to be at the Warriors game on Tuesday? Are you on Instagram? Put it out there. I'll put, you know, I'll feature your Instagram photos on here afterward if you put them up there. Ding, got it. Okay, I don't know if 831 heard that or if 831 is gone. Let's see here. Rick Rice, ha ha ha. They had to squeeze in those few people together in Las Vegas to make it look like a big crowd. Half of them were cheerleaders. Yeah, and they were cute. Okay, I think, let me see that I miss, let's see here. Will Doozing, thank you. I'm glad you said that, saw that, brother. And Ashley Arrington says, I have to go get my waffles. I made them. They're ready. You make waffles from scratch like Ashley with the, you pour the syrup in, not the syrup, but the batter in there? Yum. Hot waffles? Yum. What do you put on them? I'm curious. Oh, that's good stuff. Hot waffles. Wow. Garden State Raider. If every owner, I think, $0 million for a team to move, why couldn't they help the Raiders build a stadium in Oakland? They already made $100 million from the Chargers and the Rams. Yeah, that's what we thought Stephen Ross was going to do. And there were inclinations that was going to happen, but you're right. However, they didn't do that with Dean Spanos in San Diego, and I think there was a feeling, well, hey, if we help you, we have to help other people. But the bottom line is the NFL should have taken a good chunk of that TV money and used it for stadiums more than they have. Because that money's going to dry up at some point with what is happening in cutting the cord on cable. Okay. One woman in the Vegas party clip nearly busted out of her jersey. Oh, jeez. Oh, that's funny, Crawford. Davis wants Vegas, that's why. Ashley Arrington, who's going to be the new host for Carrie Weaver? Maybe Regis is coming back to take the show again. Rick Rice, chicken and waffles. Yes, I make. And let's see here. Golden State Raider says that money can be used to build a new stadium. And Brian Guidry says if they traded out of the fourth round selection and picked up Ifeanyi Olungo, Elijah Lee, or Anthony Walker Jr., I'm much happier. I hear you. Okay, folks, I am. Yep, go Cubs. I'll see you. I'm going to wave good night and goodbye and good luck. It's been out here an hour. Good night, an hour? I think I feel like I've been out longer than an hour. Hold on a second. Good night, everybody. Good night, everybody. I just want to see. I wonder if I can get somebody like a Charlie Sheen on here. I want to get a special guest. Good night, everybody. Somebody that you think, oh my God, he got him. Or her, you know? Hold on a second. Let me see here. You've been on here for, 1 hour and 3 minutes. That's right. So good night, everybody. Good night. Good night, everybody. Good night. I'll see you guys. Thank you. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow. I'll see you guys.